So I thought I'd do kind of a short video to just say when and why I would put a really tiny, it's called like a safety hole in an egg. So this is the air cell end of a goose egg, and you can probably hear the goose, the little gosling in there. She internally pipped on Tuesday, and today's Thursday, and she's now just starting to do her hatching, unzipping process. So sometime after she internally pipped, I candled the egg so I could see where she was inside, and I used one end, just one side of these really sharp tweezers, and I very carefully popped a hole in the shell right here, and you can see it's still there. She externally pipped over here. And I just made it that big, just super small, just barely got through the membrane, and I just left it like that. And that way, a lot of people don't believe in doing that. I do it because then I don't have to worry about whether or not she's got enough air, if she's stuck and then she's in there, and I think that's often what people worry about the most, I guess, is just that they don't get enough air. Generally, they're fine on their own, but I just do that because I'm a worrier and I haven't found any actual negative effects of doing that yet. So I've done it with a lot of eggs and they've all been okay. This little hole here is a hole that she made, and I just tore away a tiny little bit of the membrane. That's probably even more, like, could have been half that size and been done the same thing. It's just to make sure there's air getting in there without drying out the membrane too much, which drying out the membrane is the concern that people have when they do make any kind of little holes, because if it gets too dry, then it makes it harder for her to hatch. But as you can hear, he or she is breaking out, making lots of noise, pushing on the shell, so she'll be out probably, I'd say probably in about an hour. Still, they all vary. I've had a duck that started doing this and he was out in 15 minutes, but geese generally take a little longer. She'll probably be an hour, maybe two. So anyway, that's why I do an air hole. If you're gonna do it, just be really careful the bird isn't underneath where you're popping a hole, and just make it really, really tiny. All it's gonna do is just provide a tiny little bit of extra oxygen into that air cell so that if they are having a harder time hatching, they can take a rest and breathe before they continue. Generally, from internal pip to external pip, it's about 2 days. So if it's been a day and your bird just hasn't externally pipped yet, that's quite all right. But if you are worried, you can make a tiny little hole like that before you go to the trouble of peeling an egg, because most people peel an egg too soon, which of course will kill your bird. All right, I'm gonna go deal with her sister who's crying because she's by herself in the brooder.